celebrate the 30th Sunday in ordinary time. We have a few short announcements before the start of Mass. Holy Family is complying with all state mandates, and at this time, no changes to our current procedures are deemed necessary. We continue to strongly encourage everyone to wear a face covering throughout Mass, and please do your best to maintain proper social distancing. During communion, the Eucharist will be brought to you, and at this time, it is highly encouraged that you receive in the hand. However, if your conscience dictates that you receive on the tongue, we ask if you are able, you kneel by your seat as the Eucharist approaches and raise your chin. Our celebrant for this morning Mass is Father Joe, assisted by Deacon Dan.
If honored be God's name, our family embraces all, whose Father is the same.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the Lord be with you. Brothers and sisters, that we might celebrate these sacred and joyful mysteries, we prepare our hearts. We call to mind those times that we've sinned, and we ask for God's pardon and peace.
You are sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, increase our faith, hope, and charity, and make us love what you command so that we may merit what you promise. through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Thank you, Lord.
A reading from the book of Exodus. Thus says the Lord, you shall not molest or oppress an alien, for you were once aliens yourself in the land of Egypt. You shall not wrong any widow or orphan. If ever you wrong them, they will cry out to me. I will surely hear their cry. My wrath will flare up, and I will kill you with a sword. Then your own wives will be widows and your children orphans. If you lend money to one of your poor neighbors among my people, you shall not act like an extortioner toward him by demanding interest from him. If you take your neighbor's cloak as a pledge, you shall return it to him before sunset. For this cloak of his is the only covering he has for his body. What else has he to sleep in? If he cries out, if he cries out to me, I will hear him, for I am compassionate. The word of the Lord.
I love you, Lord, my strength. I love you, Lord, my strength. O Lord, my rock, my fortress, my Savior. I love you, Lord, my strength, my strength. My God, my rock where I take refuge, my shield, my saving strength, my stronghold. I cry out, praise be the Lord, and see I am saved from my foes. I love you, Lord, my strength, my strength. The Lord lives, and blessed be my rock. May the God of my salvation be exalted. The Lord gives great victories to his king, and shows merciful love for his anointed. I love you, Lord, my strength. My strength.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. Brothers and sisters, you know what sort of people we were among you for your sake. And you became imitators of us and of the Lord, receiving the word in great affliction with joy from the Holy Spirit, so that you became a model for all the believers in Macedonia and Achaia. For from you the word of the Lord has sounded forth not only in Macedonia and in Achaia, but in every place your faith in God has gone forth, so that we have no need to say anything. For they themselves openly declare about us what sort of reception we had among you, and how you turned to God from idols to serve the living and true God, and to await his Son from heaven, whom he raised from the dead, Jesus, who delivers us from the coming wrath. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Hallelujah. life. You have the words of everlasting life. Alleluia.
Lord be with you.
And with your
a reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, Lord.
When the Pharisees heard that Jesus had silenced the Sadducees, they gathered together, and one of them, a scholar of the law, tested him by asking, "Teacher, which commandment in the law is the greatest?" He said to him, "You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all your mind. This is the greatest and the first commandment. The second is like it. You shall love your neighbor as yourself. The whole law and the prophets depend on these two commandments." The Gospel of the Lord.
Sadducees. You remember last week?
Yep.
Oh, get out. Okay. Well, then I'll just stop. Yeah, you wish. Sadducees and Pharisees. And I love the beginning because this is so human, right? Basically, think of it this way. It actually mostly works, okay? See, when the Pharisees heard Jesus silenced the Sadducees, which is a great thing to say, silenced the Sadducees. When the Democrats heard that Jesus had silenced the Republicans,
yeah,
it works. They gathered together and decided to test him. Right? Hey, he shut down the people we don't agree with. Let's make sure he's on our side. That's what it came down to. And what in the end is his answer? Yeah, I'm not a Democrat. I'm not a Republican. I'm love. Love. And what word did he use for love? Did you catch Dr. Lee, the doctors, Lee, chose ubi caritas, right, for our opening, right? Yeah, okay. I get my masses mixed up. Where charity and love prevail. Okay. Charity, caritas, that's the word in Latin, right? What does caritas mean? We translate it love. And it means love in action, caritas, love in action. And if you have a child, you know this love, and that it has zero to do with your feelings. Yeah? Some of you giggled, some of you just started to weep. Yeah. What we feel is totally irrelevant to this love. What I want us to do is look at this now. When Jesus says, you must love the Lord your God with all your heart, soul, mind, and your neighbor as yourself, the word for love is love in action. It has zero to do with what you feel. Warm feelings. Happy feelings. I make a butterfly. It has to do with a firm resolution and an action. Brian Stoffregen is one of my favorite exegetes, and he wrote this whole great rip that I was going to read to you, but then I thought, don't do that to them. But he did this whole thing. He didn't have warm feelings as we were tearing him to pieces. He didn't have warm feelings for us or for the disciples while his suffering and death was happening. What he had was a firm resolution. And that firm resolution took action. And so when Jesus says that the answer is not left or right, the answer is love, then we better get after it. We better get after love and be less concerned with, everything. And make our primary concern a firm resolution that takes action. And what's that resolution? I'll love you like God loves me. I will do for you as best I can as a broken, sinful person what God has done for me. Has God ever given up on me? Not that I'm aware of. Has God ever shut me out because I have something wrong? No. Our God has made and lives a firm resolution for my betterment that takes root in action, and you and I got to do the same. Today, ask Jesus that this Eucharist that we're going to receive fundamentally transforms us to make him our highest priority. This part of the world, this part of our existence, us on earth, it's the shortest part of our existence. The Bible says it's 70 years, 80 for you who are strong. But that was before multivitamins, all right? That was funny. I didn't plan that. However long we live, flash in the pan, Scripture calls it a puff of smoke compared to the eternity of after this. When we will be with our God outside of time. Like, I look around, I see all these beautiful little squeakers, and I always tell parents this. That child's soul will outlast our son. It will outlast time. That blows me away when I see parents with a little squeaker, and some of you probably are so sick of hearing this. Your love was so real that it created something that will last forever. But that's true of you too. This eternal existence is what we're striving for, and we let that contextualize our decisions on earth so that our faith in God is a firm resolution that takes action, not a convenience, not a secondary to sports, not a secondary to academics or to money, but a primary place. God, I make a firm resolution to you. I remember this story is kind of legend in our home. We could not be late to Mass. I don't know what would ever happen if we were late to Mass as a family, but I suspect it involved Jesus returning, right? And some of that was practical. There were 8 million of us. We were a voting block, right? So one time heading out the door, something happened that made Dad the last guy in the car, which that was really unusual. And so we're packed in the car, we drive to Mass, we get there, we're at Mass, we come home, Dad asks for pliers and pulls the nail that he had stepped on out of his foot. Now, when you're a kid watching your dad with the pliers and realize he was at Mass with a pierced foot, like Jesus, I don't want to brag, it's my dad, but he didn't want to be late. Now, I'm not going to pull that off. Okay, if I ever step on a nail, Mass will be late, and I will be crying, all right? But my God, as a kid, I was little, and I remember it, because I was like, oh, it's that important to him. And I know that's crazy, but my gosh, I never forgot it. He wasn't, that was just to be late to Mass, not do I go or not. That is me as a kid looking at him and going, okay, those are the rules. And I learned that. And I'm so grateful. We have to be convinced of this in such a way that we say to God, I will love you, meaning you will be first. And my actions will back it up whether I feel like it or not. This also applies then to our love for neighbor. Some of us, we don't like everyone, hey? God never says we have to like anyone. Thank God. But he says we got to love everyone, meaning a firm resolution outside of our feelings that takes action. And I hope we heard that first reading, man. It scares me. It does sometimes when our Lord's like, do you get that if you mess with an immigrant and they cry out to me, did you catch this? I'll hear it and kill you. Oh, that's fairly to partly cloudy strong. I guess I should be conscious of how I take care of those around me. Immigrants, widows, orphans. It's not I got some extra cash, I got some extra time, so I'll help the most vulnerable. It is a firm resolution that takes the form of action. I will serve. I know you're sick of me saying this. I'm sick of obsessing about it. We're so caught up in politics. If we were this passionate about our faith, we'd change the world. $11 billion. I looked it up last night. $11 billion. That's what people have contributed to our two presidential candidates. $11 billion. Can you imagine if we were that committed to the most vulnerable among us? Can you imagine if we actually put our money where Jesus' mouth is? Wow. What are we to do with this command to love God? I'm not sure because I suspect it's a bit different for each of us. But here's what I know is true for all of us. We need to ensure that in our hearts lives for God and each other a firm resolution that takes action. If I can help you, I will. Not if it's convenient, not if I like you, not if I agree with you, not if we look the same, but because you're God's kid. And Jesus flat out said to do it. So this is the thing I kept writing down in my journal this week. I got to get better at firm resolution. I'm pretty good at feelings. I always know how I feel. How about you? Do I always know what I'm commanded to do? Well, we do now. We do now, hey? A Democrat heard that Jesus silenced a Republican, so he said, "Are you on my side?" And Jesus said, "No, I'm on the side of love." And so are we. So are we. We will, by the grace of God, love him with a firm resolution that trumps how we feel. And that love will take action, or it's just words. And we will apply it to God, and we will apply it to each other, and we will let that reality change us and the world around us. Amen?
Amen.
Okay. Let's rise and profess our faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. With confidence in our Father who hears us, we offer our prayers.
For the church, may God help us remain faithful to all of his commandments and grow in the fullness of the truth. Let us pray to the Lord. For all those in positions of power, may they be given prudence and courage in serving with justice. Let us pray to the Lord. For those who are ill with the virus, may Jesus, the divine physician, offer them hope and provide healing. Let us pray to the Lord. May the Lord protect all of those working on our church renovation, bless the work of their hands, and draw them closer to his most sacred heart. Let us pray to the Lord. For all the prayers that we hold deep in our hearts, and for those written in the parish book of intercessions, let us pray to the Lord. For our beloved dead, especially for all Holy Family parishioners who died on this date, including Margaret Bender, Margaret Gibson, Lorraine Welling, Ruth Atherholt, Helen Tabbitt, and Anne Marguerite Margie Smith. And for those who died this past week, especially John Mott and Barbara Helms, mother of Cindy Bronson, let us pray to the Lord. And for the repose of the soul of Myrtle Pletos, for whom this Mass is being offered, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Father in heaven, we offer you our prayers. We trust that in your love, in your mercy, and in your time, you will give us everything we need. We make this prayer of faith in the name of Jesus, our Lord. Amen. As we are seated for the altar, I just wanted to take a moment and acknowledge and thank all of you who have been giving during this time. I know it's different without taking a collection, but between the digital online thing, whatever that's called, right, and that clear box out there, and the people in our digital parish, I'm just so blessed by your generosity, and I want to make sure you know that. I thank the Lord for you. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life. Blessed be God forever. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink. Blessed be God forever. With humble spirit and contrite heart, may we be accepted by you, O Lord, and may our sacrifice in your sight this day be pleasing to you, Lord God. O Lord, wash me of my iniquities and cleanse me of my sins. And thank you, Lord, for this holy deacon. Thank you, brother. Okay. Please rise and pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, our Almighty Father. Accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. Look, we pray, O Lord, on the offerings we make to your majesty, that whatever is done by us in your service may be directed above all to your glory. Through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord. Holy Father, almighty and eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For out of compassion for the waywardness that is ours, he humbled himself and was born of the Virgin. By the passion of the cross, he freed us from unending death. And by rising from the dead, he gave us life eternal. And so, with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim. Blessed is he who comes in the You are indeed holy, and to be glorified, O God, who love the human race, and who always walk with us on the journey of life. Blessed indeed is your Son, present in our midst when we are gathered by his love. And when, as once for the disciples, so now for us, he opens the scriptures and breaks the bread. Therefore, Father most merciful, we ask that you send forth your Holy Spirit to sanctify these gifts of bread and wine, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, on the night of the Last Supper, he took bread and said the blessing. He broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." Similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, gave you thanks, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, Holy Father, as we celebrate the memorial of Christ, your Son, our Savior, whom you led through his passion and death on the cross to the glory of the resurrection, and whom you have seated at your right hand, we proclaim the work of your love until he comes again, and we offer you the bread of life and the chalice of blessing. Look with favor on the oblation of your church, in which we show forth the paschal sacrifice of Christ that has been handed on to us. And grant that by the power of the Spirit of your love, we may be counted now and until the day of eternity among the members of your Son, in whose body and blood we have communion. Bring your church, O Lord, to perfect faith and charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Earl, our Bishop, with all bishops, priests, and deacons, and your entire people you have made your own. Open our eyes to the needs of our brothers and sisters. Inspire in us words and actions to comfort those who labor and are burdened. Make us serve them truly after the example of Christ and at his command. And may your church stand as a living witness to truth and freedom, to peace and justice, that all people may be raised to a new hope. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the peace of your Christ and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. Admit them to rejoice in the light of your face, and in the resurrection give them fullness of life. Grant also to us, when our earthly pilgrimage is done, that we may come to an eternal dwelling place and live with you forever. There, in communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the apostles and martyrs, and with all the saints, we shall praise and exalt you through Jesus Christ, your Son. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Agnus Dei, qui tonis peccata mundi, miserere nobis. Agnus Dei, qui tonis peccata mundi, miserere nobis. Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, dona nobis pace.
Eternal life to us who receive it. Thank you, Jesus. Lord Jesus Christ, Son of the living God, who by the will of the Father and work of the Holy Spirit through your death gave life to the world, free me by this your most holy body and blood from all my sins and from every evil. Keep me always faithful to your commandments and never let me be parted from you. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. And may the body of Christ keep me safe for eternal life.
For those watching the digital community this morning, unable to participate in the Eucharist, we invite you to recite the spiritual communion prayer with us. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Well, since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Let our soul rejoice and be
now and always. Let everyone love the Lord God, the living God, and with sincere hearts let us love each other. Sed amor Deus ibi est, congregavi nos in unum Christi amor, exultemus et in ipso iucundemur. Time amus et amemus Deum vivum, et escorde diligamus nos in cero. Ubi caritas et amor Deus ibi ergo cum in unum congregamur, ne nos mentes dividamur, caveamus. Ce seniurgia maligna cesset liter, et in medio nostris id Christus Deus. Which true love and charity are found, God is always there. Therefore when we gather as one in Christ Jesus, let our love infold each race, creed, every person. Let envy, division, and strife cease among us. May Christ our Lord dwell among us in every heart. Ubi caritas et amor Deus ibi est. Blessed be the Lord. I will bless the Lord at all times, with praise ever in my mouth. Let my soul glory in the Lord, who will hear the cry of the poor. The Lord of the poor. Blessed be the Lord. Let the lowly hear and be glad. The Lord listens to their pleas, and to hearts broken God is near. Who will hear the cry of the poor? Lord hears the cry of the poor. Blessed be the Lord. Every spirit crushed God will save. Will be ransom for their lives. Will be safe, shelter for their fears. Blessed be the
Let us pray. Okay, Lord. May your sacraments, O Lord, we pray, perfect in us what lives in them, that what we now celebrate in signs we may one day possess in truth, through Christ our Lord. Amen. I was bringing notes for today's homily because I had one all the way to Wednesday, and then Thursday it changed, and you got both, and I'm really sorry. Basically, what I want us to walk away with is that firm resolution. Hey, we're going to love God with our actions and each other with our actions. So I could have just said that. So I don't know if you've noticed, but each week we've been displaying a new Eucharistic miracle in the lobby. It's really cool. It's part of an effort to help us to see all the wonders through time and history that our God has done through the gift of this Eucharist. So is that the new one? Okay, groovy. Right over there is the new one, and then there's details in our bulletin that you can read about this. So just be conscious of that. For the next many months, I believe, you're going to see a different board up every week and then a corresponding article in the bulletin that will help us look at that miracle and grow in our sense of wonder for this ridiculously great gift God has given us. Keep up the prayers for the church. They're moving right along now. The floor is almost completely tiled. And my gosh, I in the next week or two, our pews are going to go in. So we're getting there, guys. And I'm so grateful. And I pray every time you pass it, please pray, right? Ask Jesus to go ahead of us and prepare that place with his Spirit. Okay. The Lord be with you. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Go forth and announce the gospel of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Michael, the archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray. And thou, O Prince of the heavenly hosts, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl throughout the world, seeking the ruin of souls. Amen. Thank you, Lord.
the Spirit, we are one in the Lord. We are one in the Spirit, we are one in the Lord. And we pray that all unity may one day be restored. And they know we are Christian by our love, yes, they win. We are Christians by our love. We will walk with each other.